सी क्रिप्टोकोकोसिस, ओके, क्रिप्टोकोकोसिस इज अ डिजीज, ऐसे रखते हैं, स्लाइड शो नहीं करते. Cryptococcus is caused by mainly the Cryptococcus neoformans, okay, and sometimes it is caused by the Cryptococcus getty, but most commonly it is caused by the Cryptococcus neoformans. So it affects the variety of the animals as well as the human, okay, but there is a no connection between the animal diseases and human diseases. This is not transmitted from animal to human, but this is cause disease in variety of the mammals and human also, okay. So there are various synonyms of the disease, that is torulosis, torula meningitis, is known as the European blastomycosis or Bussy Buskey's disease. Actually torulosis is actually genus, previously instead of Cryptococcus this is known as the torula neoformans, that's why it is known as the torulosis. Means based on that genus name, it is known as the torulosis. Or main symptom.
Ma'am, क्या बोली ma'am? Repeat करेंगे please.
हाँ, okay. Actually, this is caused by the genus Cryptococcus neoformans. Okay, but some previous literature, you see the name of the genus is not the Cryptococcus, that was Torula neoformans. So based on that, it is also known as the torulosis. Okay, torulosis or Torula meningitis, because causes the meningitis symptom. So this is known as the torula meningitis also. European, this disease is known as the European blastomycosis. Okay. And another disease is there, we'll see later. That is known as the North American blastomycosis. So these are some common names of the disease. Torulosis, torula meningitis, European blastomycosis, Bussy Buskey's disease, based on some symptoms. Okay. Based on that prevalence of that area. Okay, these are the various synonyms. So this organism is mainly present in the environment. Okay, this organism is mainly present in the environment, or it is the main habitat of this organism is the digestive tract of the bird. So bird feces, which contains creatinine, which is a source of nitrogen, which favors the growth of that particular fungus. So the nitrogen source, which is present in the fecal material of the bird, is the main source of the source for the growth factor for the micro that fungus. Okay. So this is present. It is a saprophyte, which is present in the soil nest. Other site, it is contaminated with the excreta of the pigeon or other birds like parrot and canaries. So These are the habit or habitat, you can say, where this fungus is mainly present. Okay, main route is inhalation, and sometimes that this causes the direct inoculation. Okay, inoculation of the wound, inoculation in the wound, or some abrasion in the wound. Then this fungus can fungal spore. Actually, in fungal spore is mainly infectious. Source, okay, fungal spore spread here and there, or through the inhalation we can inhale the fungal spore, or if there is a contamination of the wound, then fungal spore can enter into the wound and it causes a localized systemic infection, severity or wound status of the patient, either animal or human. Okay, so this in cattle buffalo it causes a mammary gland infection, means it causes a mastitis to enter into the canal. Okay. So, and as I already told, this is not transmitted from one host to another. So directly it is not transmitted, just like dermatophytes, by touching. Okay. So these are the various this is the epidemiology of the Cryptococcus. Now you see the disease. Here you see in animals it causes the rare or sporadic cases. Okay, and mainly it is characterized by the granulomatous meningitis. आप लोग प्लीज अपना ऑडियो म्यूट कीजिए, ऑडियो म्यूट कीजिए प्लीज, आवाज आ रही है इस पे. ओके, सो इट मेनली कॉजेस द मेनिंजियोएन्सेफलाइटिस इन केस ऑफ एनिमल्स. सो इन डॉग एंड कैट आल्सो इट कॉज द मेनिंजाइटिस, एंड इन कैटल बफेलो इट कॉजेस द मेन सिम्टम इज मैस्टाइटिस, and pneumonia. Cryptococcal pneumonia, it causes the, this is spelling mistake actually, cryptococcal. See, the cryptococcal pneumonia. It causes the meningitis, and in cattle or buffalo, it causes the mastitis and the pneumonia. Okay. And in case of man, in healthy person, this organism does not cause the disease. Or you can say man is resistant to the infection. But in immunocompromised person, where you are using corticosteroid or antibiotic, broad spectrum antibiotic for the longer period, then it decreases the immunity. Or if the person is infected with some metabolic disorder like the diabetes, then it also causes the lower the immunity. In that case, this fungus causes the disease. There are the various form of the disease, like cutaneous form, subcutaneous form, pulmonary form, and that's here you see disseminated form, disseminated or the cerebral form. Actually, the cerebral form is already, it's a form of disseminated form. Okay, here you see first is cutaneous form. Cutaneous form means there is a infection of the wound or abrasion through the fungal spore, so it causes the formation of the papules or abscess. And later it caused the ulceration of the wound. So in cutaneous form, it caused the papulic lesion, which become abscess, means there is a formation of the pus, and later it become ulcerate. So in first form is the cutaneous form. If second form is the pulmonary form, if you are inhaling the spores, accidentally inhalation of the spore causes the cryptococcoma infection. That cryptococcoma is the formation of the fungus mass in the lung. So it causes the cryptococcoma in the lung. This is a mass of the fungus which is present in the lung and causes the some symptoms like the fever, cough, chest pain, and the hemoptysis. Okay, so this is the pulmonary form where you are inhaling the, when you are inhaling the spores, then it causes the pulmonary form. Okay, and if the from that pulmonary form, it spread into the bloodstream, that cryptococcoma, and this mass can be disseminated to the various organ. Okay, and either in the mucosa, it may travel to the brain, or it causes the osseous form if it travels to the brain, bones. So in disseminated form, based on that place, it will show the symptoms. So most common or most lethal is the cerebral form. If that cryptococcoma mass, it travels into the CNS, then it will lead to some symptoms like meningitis, meningoencephalitis. Okay, and this disease lasts for week or month. Up to week or month, we can observe the symptoms like headache, visual disturbance, and personality changes with the person, leads to a confusion, agitation, and lethargy. Okay, so this disease is fatal. If it is fatality, it is, if you are not going for the treatment, proper treatment. Okay, so these are the various form of the cryptococcus, where if the person is healthy, then it does not cause any disease. But if the person is immunocompromised or having some pre-existing diseases like the diabetes, and then it leads to the that fungus supersede and cause the disease, and it will show the various form like cutaneous, pulmonary, and disseminated form. Mainly is the cerebral form, and these are the symptoms, and mainly cerebral form is the fatal. Okay, these are the some picture of the cutaneous form. You see there is a papule like lesion which becomes abscessic, and later it forms the ulcers. Okay, these are the mainly symptoms of the cutaneous form. So come to the diagnosis. You can demonstrate the fungus from the lesion. Okay, you can collect the sample specimen, and you can go for the observation. You can observe the hyphae of the characteristic of the fungus. Okay, and you can go for the culture. You can use the several gastroagar, and you can see it will show the colonies. Later on, you can observe this colony under the microscope. okay, you can go for the MRI CT scan if that to observe the fungal cryptococcoma in the lungs. Then you can go for the MRI, and you can also diagnose the fungal antibody which is from present in the blood or urine. So this you can diagnose the fungal antibody which is present either in the blood or urine through the serodiagnostic techniques like ELISA. Okay, and antifungal chemotherapy you can use the amphotericin B and azole solution the like ketoconazole, fluconazole, itraconazole as like various fungal diseases. Okay, and in prevention control mainly we have to decrease the use of the corticosteroid or broad spectrum antibiotics. Okay, so avoid such condition which lowers the immunity. Okay, if avoid contact with the mainly patient if you are entering to that area, try to cover your mask, handle with the gloves. Okay, if you are removing the that patient excreta, then use the chemical disinfectant to kill the fungus. So these are the various preventive measures for the cryptococcosis. These are the very small diseases. You need not to go in the deep for the UG, okay? Because if you are going in detail, then it will take whole one class. So there is no need to go in deep. This is sufficient, okay? Next disease is zygomycosis. Zygomycosis, okay? Okay, zygomycosis, or it is also known as the micromycosis, or phycomycosis, or entomophromycosis. So these are the various synonyms. Micromycosis is caused by the zygomycetes fungus. Okay, this zygomycetes fungus, which is having the micromycorrhizas and entomophromycorrhizas, these are two order. Okay, under the zygomycetes, these are the family. Okay, so the under this based on that order, you can call this is the micromycosis or the entomophromycosis based on that species. Various species are involved of this order. Okay, so this is mainly caused by this genus of the Absidia, Conidobolus, Rhizomucor, Rhizopus microsporus. These are the various fungus involved to cause the disease zygomycosis. Okay, this belongs to the either micromycorrhizas or the entomophromycorrhizas. Okay, so here also disease is mainly caused in the immunocompromised person. Same situation as if your person is taking too much broad spectrum, so the long period they are taking the broad spectrum antibiotic or the corticosteroid, then it will lead to an infection. As usual, this is the saprophyte, which is mainly present in the organic matter in the nature. Okay, and this disease caused disease in domestic animal as well as in the man. And here you can say the entry is either inhalation or ingestion or also by the inoculation of the organism. Okay, these are the various means by this fungus can take entry. Okay, so this is also not transmissible from one host to another. Okay, by direct contact. Here you see, come to the disease in animals. Here you mainly it is caused by granulomatous lesion in the mesenteric or mediastinal lymph nodes. So main lesion is the granulomatous lesion, MAS. Okay, granulomatous lesion means there is a MAS which is mainly present in the mesenteric or mediastinal lymph node, which affects the mesenteric means gastrointestinal, related to gastrointestinal tract. Okay, and disseminated to various organs like the kidney, liver, and brain. Okay, it is also cause the disseminated infection and affects the kidney, liver, or brain. Here also, when you see in case of pigs or young calves, it mainly affect the alimentary canal or causes the gastritis, vomition, diarrhea, and ulcers. These are the some symptoms. Okay, and means mainly it affects the GIT if it is disseminated form, then various visceral organs is also affected, and symptoms you will observe it is the gastrointestinal symptoms like the the vomition, diarrhea, and ulcer in the GIT. So these are the various symptoms in case of animal, and in human you see there is also just like cryptococcus, there are various form of this disease. If you are taking entering the fungus through the inhalation, then it will lead to pulmonary form. Okay, then radiocerebral subcutaneous form, gastrointestinal form, cutaneous or subcutaneous form. Here pulmonary already understood. If you are taking fungal spore through inhalation, then it causes the pulmonary symptoms in the lungs. Okay, thereafter it if it is in disseminated form, then it causes the it enters into the GIT. If and if it is entering through the cutaneous route, like through the burn, if you are application of the bandage, if you are applicating some bandage to the burn or scratches, if it is contaminated with fungal spore, then fungal enter into the body. It is main cause. It is observed in the various endemic region. Okay, the infected use of infected bandage. Okay, elastic bandages. So it causes the cutaneous form or subcutaneous form. Okay, if it is spread to the brain, then it will lead to the death also. Okay, here you see rhinocerebral subcutaneous form. Actually, rhinocerebral infection means it affects the mainly the sinuses which is present in the brain or in the nose. Mainly, it starts with the nasal sinus, or it may transmit to the eye socket or brain, or sometimes the bones also here. So it causes the edema. Edema, we'll see edema of the face and edema and disfiguring. You'll see there is a face maybe disturbed or because of this lesion, mainly this eye lesion. Okay, so this causes the this is the rhinocerebral subcutaneous form. Mainly this fungus causes the occlusion of the vascular system. Okay, occlusion means there is fungal mass will the fungal mass which accumulate into the blood vessels. Okay, and it will inhibit the circulation. Then it will lead to edema and necrosis of the particular part. This is actually pathogenesis, and that's why it is here. Okay, here you see actually this is the subcutaneous lesion. You see, okay, will reddish lesion which is highlighted. This is subcutaneous lesion which is present, which is caused by the micro. And here you see there is a edema of the face. Okay, edema of the face due to the rhinocerebral micromycosis. It will affect the sinus, nasal sinus, and eye socket, and brain. Finally, edema of the face and disfiguring of the face. So these are the symptoms. Here you see, that's I already told you, it causes the vascular occlusion. Okay, and it causes the thrombosis, and later it causes the necrosis of the particular affected part. Okay, and another is entomophoromycosis. This is called by the other genus, other order of the zygomycetes. It is mainly caused by the Basidiobolus hepatosporus. This is the mainly fungus involved in the causing the entomophoromycosis. So it causes the granulomatous eosinophil infiltration mainly in subcutaneous lesion. Okay, here you see in subcutaneous here mainly buttock or thigh lesion is affected. Here you see there is a occlusion, or there is a formation of the granuloma mass in the subcutaneous lesion of the thigh lesion. So mainly symptom is similar, but here the causative agent is somewhat different. Okay, then caused by the Basidiobolus of this family, this order. These are the main symptoms which is caused in zygomycosis by the various fungus of the micromycosis and the, that is एंटोमोथ्रोमाइकोसिस. ओके सो नाउ डायग्नोसिस डायग्नोसिस इज डन बाय द आइसोलेशन और डिटेक्शन ऑफ द फंगस फंगल स्पोर and you can go for the isolation identification on the sebos destro agar media it will grow and for the treatment you can go for the if it is localized infection or cutaneous infection you can go for the ketoconazole solution for topical administration and if it is in disseminated systemic form then you can go for the potassium iodate and azithromycin B drugs okay and here that mainly the prevention and control mainly if you have to first one is the stop the in the long term use of the antibiotic or corticosteroid or subside the use that metabolic diseases like diabetes okay if the person is alcoholic for the long time it also suppress the immunity so avoid such conditions and here copper sulfate is useful okay if the water contains the fungal spore then you can use copper sulfate for the killing of the fungal spore and in case of animal avoid to give moldy hay or for the feed so you can in animal mainly you can avoid by the giving them the healthy food mainly to the animals means there is a main mode in animals is the ingestion okay so these are the various 20 measures through which can you can avoid such conditions okay so this is all for today okay okay actually ha kyunki do padhane bola gaya tha aur main record karna bhul gayi kya nahi record kiya hai
रिकॉर्ड हुआ है
थैंक यू मैम
और कुछ डाउट है तो पूछो एक्चुअली क्या है ना क्योंकि पिछले बार छूट गए थे कुछ टॉपिक जो हमने कमिट किए थे कुछ टॉपिक वो टॉपिक छूट गए